Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am Liliti and here we talk about money and general lifestyle issues. Today we'll be talking about networking in a professional setting. So what is networking? Networking is interacting with people to exchange information and develop professional or social contacts. It can also be described as making contact and exchanging information with other people, groups, or institutions to develop mutually beneficial relationships. Networking is vital to career growth, and it enables you to be known and to be on the top of the mind of people in the event that there are opportunities that are relative to your line of work or something like that. Needless to say, it is very important for everyone, and especially if you're seeking to grow career-wise. It helps you to, there are benefits to networking. So I'll give you the reasons to networking. These are to strengthen business connections, because when you're going out there, you're putting yourself out there, you're meeting people, you're sharing. It is always about sharing and not taking. So you give and take, not just taking. So this one, it is reciprocal in nature, and so you are strengthening your business connections. You get fresh ideas, because these are people that you did not know otherwise, or people you had not had such conversations with, and every time you meet someone, best believe that something will rub off you. Number three, it raises your profile, because now you're relating, you're putting yourself out there. You're meeting new people, obviously you'll be rated higher than you were before. Number four, it advances your career growth. This is through, like, you attend professional and social events, you meet people, learn of opportunities, and so you are able to apply early enough and get the position most likely. Number five, you get access to job opportunities. So the more you expand your contacts, the more you're in the top of mind of people that are aware of job opportunities, and so they let you know. And you are also in the top of their minds, and they are able to consider you. Number six, you gain more knowledge. You learn to get to know about the best practices in your line of career, about business techniques, and also industry development. You also get in contact with people that are posting in LinkedIn. You follow them, you check what they are posting, and you are always in the know. Seven, you're able to get career advice and support. When you go to such meetings, you can ask about your common you can talk about common challenges and opportunities, and so you get suggestions and guidance on how to deal and handle them. Number eight, you build confidence. As number seven has said, you get career advice and support. So with that backing you up, you are also aware, you are more confident, and you have also developed your social skills, and you've made lasting connections. Number nine, you gain a different perspective. Sometimes you're stuck in a rat race, but when you go and talk to other people, then you get fresh eyes on your on your issues, and you're able to overcome roadblocks that may have been stopping you previously. Number 10, you get to make long-lasting personal relationships. So these are majorly people who are like-minded with similar goals as you, and so you will relate easily. You'll most likely be vibing on the same level, and so it will be easier to connect and make friends that will last beyond the event. You are able to get answers to almost every question. So this is a meetup of people who are in the same industry, maybe. So whatever question you have, I am sure someone will be knowledgeable on it, and even if not, then you have a solid sounding board to bounce off ideas and to get a fresh thinking on the problem that you may be having. You may be able to get, this may be opportunity that you have to get your dream job or the job that you love, because there are so many people in different industries, and the more people you know, obviously, like in our country, the likelier that you will be the first to know in the, when the big jobs comes up, you will get to hear them. And also, you never know who will be sitting on the board. Also, there's this pun in Kenya that jobs are no longer given over in the boardroom, but rather in over drinks. So the less formal of an event you meet, the likelier that you are able to talk freely, and maybe you can tell people that you're in the lookout. You can put it out there that you're searching, and so if they know of opportunities, they will be able to tell you. So where do you get to network? I'll just list a few. That you can attend job fairs. Those are the best because those ones already are targeted towards a certain career. Professional associations, you can subscribe to your professional body, like there's CASNEB, there's LSK and such. You can attend public speaking events like the TED and such. You can attend alumni events. You can meet up with your the people you were in school with, so that you know where they are and maybe they can help you out, or maybe you can just build that network. You never know when you will need it. Networking events, the events that are organized just for networking. Professional development classes, you can take a professional development class and you never know who you will meet there. Professional conferences, these are organized and about industry development and such. So when you go to these events, don't just leave immediately, you're done. When it's over, maybe you can go introduce yourself, talk to people, let people remember your face. That's how it will last. You can volunteer for charities and other volunteer opportunities, like, you know, sometimes there's also tree planting. Totally unrelated, but then again, you don't know who else is volunteering. Cultural events, sports tournaments, and other online meetups you can attend. And the best thing is to go introduce yourself, talk about yourself, be of help to other people, listen carefully and follow up on conversations, offer assistance. That way they will know you're reliable and you're offering your expertise, and you're also knowledgeable and supportive. This one speaks highly to yourself. So when someone is hiring, they already know this about you, and you never know. Recruiters are always on the lookout in such events, and you never know who you will bump into. You never know who you will sip tea with. You never know who you're having that chit chat with. That may be your next employer, or that may be the HR in your new workplace. So that will be all. I am Leliti. Kindly like, subscribe and share, and see you in the next one.